Hello, I am Arash Lavasan. I am an engineer and I work as a member of Huesker Synthetics Engineering Department in the application area of earthwork and foundation. In this videocast, I would like to introduce you to the application of finite element method to analyze the geosynthetic reinforced soil structures. In recent years, numerical simulation technique has become popular in geotechnical engineering. Depending on the nature of the problem, different classes of numerical frameworks such as finite element, finite difference, and discrete element methods have been widely used in computational geotechniques. In general, the main purpose of using numerical simulation is to get a quantitative picture of the internal forces and the stress-strain distribution in the systems. In order to establish an adequate numerical model, we have to image the reality in terms of the geometry, type of loading, and the history of construction in our numerical models. However, it's almost impossible to have a one-to-one comparison. Additionally, the engineers should make the decision about the boundary condition, the type of analysis, and most importantly, the relevant constitutive model that can capture the important features of the soil behavior. This decision is strongly dependent on the nature of the problem, the purpose of analysis, and also the availability of the model-specific data. Basically, different classes of the constitutive models, such as elastoplastic, hypoplastic, and bounding surface plasticity models with advanced features such as small strain stiffness and kinematical hardening, are available to mimic the behavior of the geomaterials. Apparently, advanced models have a larger number of the constitutive parameters which can be identified from complex laboratory tests. Besides the constitutive model, the appropriate type of the analysis, such as mechanical, hydraulic, or coupled hydromechanical analysis, has to be chosen in accordance with the physical processes in the problem and the scope of the design. The process of numerical simulation of geosynthetic reinforced soil systems is even more complicated than the standard geotechnical problems because the behavior of the reinforcement and also properties of the contact between the geosynthetic and soil have to be appropriately simulated. This includes having adequate knowledge about the tensile modulus and tensile strength of the reinforcement and also the properties of the interface. It's important to know that the tensile modulus of the reinforcement should be identified from the isochronous curves provided by the geosynthetic manufacturer for the specific type of the reinforcement. Additionally, the influence of the raw material, time scale, and stress level on the behavior of the geosynthetic layers has to be considered. Concerning different functions of the geosynthetics, the appropriate hydromechanical boundary conditions and relevant type of the analysis have to be adopted. In general, the numerical approach can be successfully employed to simulate different classes of standard geosynthetic reinforced structures, such as embankment, retaining structures, geosynthetic encased columns, piled embankments with basal reinforcement, overbridging systems, footings on reinforced paths, roads, and working platforms. For these applications, the finite element method provides a reliable platform to find the critical mechanism and to discover the key design parameter at service and ultimate load states. According to our experience, the finite element method can be utilized to identify the critical mode of the failure and the bearing capacity of the geosynthetic reinforced working platforms in both short and long terms. The numerical results indicate how the reinforcement can confine the system and affect the failure mechanism. As another example, our numerical results show that the finite element modeling of geosynthetic reinforced piled embankments can capture the fundamental aspects in the system, such as arching in the soil and the membrane effect in the basal reinforcement. Therefore, such reliable models can be employed to study the soil structure interactions under complex loading conditions. Finally, it's to be noted that the finite element analysis is not supposed to make the complex geotechnical problems easier, but it gives the opportunity for the engineers to gain a better understanding about their system behavior and to design their systems. Although there are some guidelines and recommendations for the numerical modeling in geotechniques, the finite element practitioners should have broad experience and background in both numerical modeling and geotechnical engineering to be able to assess the numerical results and to assure that the model responses are consistent with the engineering knowledge. I hope that this presentation has captured your interest. Should you wish to know more about the technical details and Huesker solutions, please take a look at our website or contact us directly. We look forward to providing you with our advice and support.